Hello, and whether if you're new or returning subscriber, welcome to my channel. Today I have the Legion of Sleepy Hollow Tarot. This is the deck that I've been waiting for such a long time. It was on Amazon pre-order, and just when it got released, they had stock problems. And it was gone off from Amazon. And I think I purchased this from Verdry. I am not sure which publication this has been printed. I'm sorry, I can't see I cannot read. Okay. Maybe I can't find it. I have this. Oh no. This is not done yet. Okay. We have this gilded sun, gold gilded sun and moon and corn. That's it. And there's a pumpkin, gilded pumpkin here. It has got 78 cards, 4 spreads, and a guidebook. And the horseman. Ichabod Crane. Okay. This is being created by Nick Love. Love here, we got this box. You know, I don't like this kind of boxes because if you're not careful, then this happens. So this has to be this. If you have this deck, you need to store it carefully. So I had three more decks in this type of box, and I'm always dropping the cards on the floor. Okay. It's a Red Feather. Okay, yeah, it's a Red Feather Publications. Copyright 2023, Nicholas Lowyer. Or it's Red Feather and Schiffer Publishing, okay. It's about the deck. The Legion of Sleepy Hollow is the story of the schoolmaster Ichabod Crane, who moves to the small dash town of Sleepy Hollow, New York. There he learns the legend of the Headless Horseman. Okay, we all know about the history, and this is the RWS style. And this is the artist here. Okay. Well, we can see Ichabod Crane is heading down to the town. Ichabod Crane. Nice. I actually like it. Okay, we have the suite, the minor arcana is not in detail like we see in the major arcana. We have just the small keywords. Let's go back. We have the spreads here, the love triangle. Ichabod Great, The Horseman's Chase, Tribal Chieftain, and The Conclusion Biography. Okay, this can go into the box. Oh, it's another matte cardstock. I'm not sure what this is on the current. So this is at the back of the card. Again, sun, moon, and pumpkins. I can see little damage on the edges of the deck already, and I have just unboxed it. The card stock is a little bit on the thin side, not thin, but it is thinner than the other decks we have just unboxed, the last two decks. I like this deck. Obviously, it is based on the Legend of the Sleepy Hollow, and my wish is I wish this deck was borderless and a little bit larger, like the Druidcraft type of deck. Also, I like how there is the hangman. Oh, it's not the hangman, justice, sorry. So then, actually, when you look at the justice cards, how it reminds me to other cards, like hanged man, you could basically hang a man with the rope. Yes, when you hang someone, it is to bring justice, and it is also that. You know, instead of, I don't know, using this card, use this, just this as a base, and I don't know that this is me. And this is my opinions. I have also, I have mentioned about the books in the beginning. It's not a very good closure. I have the similar experience on the Colleen, Colette Baron Reed's letters. The deck, the same enclosure. I have the same on the Santa Muerte deck, and I have the same issue on the Terra de la Nuit. Those are the decks that I just come to my mind, has the same enclosure. The book is obviously nice, but of course it's just a small booklet, but better than the white book that comes with the Libellane deck. So if you enjoyed my work, please like, subscribe and share. I will link the deck in the description box below. If you enjoyed my work, please like, subscribe and share, and I will see you with another video pretty much very, very soon. Bye bye, take care, ciao.